Hey, Bears 40 Warrior, welcome back to Donkey Kong 64. We finished up with Jungle Jokes, and now it's time to go to the next level. Dun da da! Here we go. And another scene with Darth Cruel. That mouse and monkey should have been burnt to a crisp by now. Where's that armadillo? We now lost his shell, apparently.
I'm sorry, Master. He was too quick. But I'll get him next time.
You won't have it next time.
Imbecile. I don't like failure. Do you know what happens to failures?
And isn't that the worst evil eye ever? The bloodshot is. Good lord.
I've waited too long for this. I will have to sleep in monkey's room. My plans this time.
I'm pretty sure my voice for those guys has changed at least 3 times by now. Anyway, Angry Aztec is our next level, and we already face our first hazard. Quicksand, which apparently behaves the same way as lava and other hazards. They simply make you go ow. And here's our first introduction to a legit Kremlin. Believe it or not, they do not hurt you on contact. They have to take a swipe at you, so. As you see, he tried taking a little bitch slap there. Failed miserably, but he tried. We'll worry about those coconut switches later. They really don't have any relevance at this point. And in there, we have a llama that is caged. The key to his freedom lies in the clouds. Well, in order to do that, we gotta get our head in the clouds. And the best way to do that is one Donkey Kong. But first, let's make a detour here to Candy's Music Shop. Yep. Looks like she's done well for herself. And yeah, that chest is very, 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 large. There's no other way of putting it. Donkey Kong, you magnificent bastard. But she doesn't care, she flirts with every one of the Kongs. So, yeah. Makes you wonder. And now that we got the music instrument, we can mess up anything. Yeah, basically any Kremlin that's around the area is gonna get blown to tiny bits. And she's also the person to come to get extra melons. Now what would she know about nice, large, firm melons? I don't know. I am so going to hell. I am so going to hell for this. Anyway. Now that we got the questionable moral part out of the way. Okay, don't act like you were thinking the same thing. God. Jeez. I know I put a lot on my audience and hopefully to act somewhat mature, but let's be honest here. Also the easiest 15 bananas in this level. And Lil Day's gotta visit his girlfriend for obvious reasons. And you'd think there'd be a special scene, but of course not. A nice little classic riff there from the original Donkey Kong Country. And now he's completely facing away from Candy, breathless. Jeez. So this is how the Kongs, flirt with each other. They look, they stare in the distance away from people, away from other Kongs. Yeah, this is where we're at, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Yeah. I should point out, she looks drastically different than she does in the CGI Donkey Kong Country show. Where I think she had like... Oh, I'm trying to remember, what was it? It's like... Basically did not look anything like that. Less features shown. More headband, Oh, whoops. Looks like I need Diddy's thing after all. Stop messing about, all the sand's starting to itch. Sand tends to do that. Have you ever been on a beach? Oof. Damn. That's the worst thing is getting right in the groin. And I think everybody here knows that feeling. It sucks. Horrible. Anyway, I don't think they gave me enough coins. They really do give you a lot of coins in this game. A very large amount. So anyway, I'm recording this and, well, hopefully when this part's up my knee will be better. It's been sore now for like 3 weeks. I was playing basketball, and, well, I haven't played basketball in a while, and I tried making a move on somebody and it failed miserably. Because you gotta know one thing about me, I play like like your stereotypical NBA, white NBA player does. Shoots the lights out, but has absolutely no game other than that. So I tried making a move, a little cross or whatever, guy didn't bite on it, and I thought I'd get around him, and we banged knees. Knee-to-knee contact, which is like the worst thing you can have in any athletic, anything athletic. Because your knee is like the number one thing you need for any athletic activity. So yeah, it's been hurting now for 3 weeks. I haven't even ran on it. For a while, I couldn't even get up and downstairs without a lot of help. It was bad. Now, I mean, it's like 92%, but it's been stuck at 92% for God knows how long. Also, hi, Tiny. How are you doing? Obviously not doing very well since you're stuck in a cell. Well, I should be able to rescue two Kongs and Angry Aztec. And, well, we have ice here. Well, that's no good. And we have our first introduction to a claptrap. Now, oranges actually do home in, which is nice. Claptraps, you can defeat two ways. You can either do what I just did, which is throw an orange at them, which will kill them instantly. But if you don't do that, and very fitting for claptraps since they'll eat anything, you can beat them up, and then a set of teeth will come after you. By itself, just completely by itself. Also, tongue platforms. Yeah. I know, really, if you're a guy, too much tongue isn't really a thing, but that's probably the closest thing you're gonna get to too much tongue. And another thin-ass platform. I wonder if I'll be able to handle this one. Also, that is too much tongue. Yeah. That better not be this platform. And these instruments that Candy had have mystical powers where they can control climate. Activate switches. Or do all-around crazy stuff. And they absolutely destroy Kremlings. Like I said, the number one way to take care of any Kremling you come across. Even those are really royal pains in the asses to beat. Although, one little caveat, you will not be able to use them against bosses, so don't even bother. And also, starfish, they are enemies. They are bitches. I hate them, they're annoying. So let's see, what we got here? We got enemies up the wazoo. And we got K-O-N-G. I wonder what this could possibly mean. Also, get out of my face. Maybe we have to spell, gonk? Nah, that can't be it. Noggig? Also, I told you that teeth will come after you. Just simply attack them the same way you would attack anything else. Got it. Kagong. Nah, you gotta spell Kong. Everybody knows that. Or anybody that's actually played a Donkey Kong game before would know that. Okay, did you get up? Time to get the Midget Kong out. Okay, I'm not insulting midgets, okay? I'm not insulting little people. I'm just simply saying what it is. Tiny is tiny. I know somebody might say something like, Jesus Christ, 40, come on. Well, that's the fact of the matter is, one of my complaints about society is we live in a very easily offensible society. Chobani came under fire because their latest advertisement was about how all their ingredients were all natural. Well, anybody that's anybody knows that yogurt is a scientific creation. It requires combining elements, chemicals, you name it, to make yogurt. Anybody has known that. But apparently some scientists were so offended by these claims that they decided to whine about them. And get an apology out of it. Like, come on. This is what our society has become, people. We're crying over very little minute stuff and ignoring things that are more big picture. I had a whole rant lined up for the whole Donald Sterling thing, but I basically just dropped that because, well, yeah. Yeah, I didn't feel like tackling issues like that. I still don't, honestly. But, I mean, that is the way I feel. It's... people are so hypersensitive now, it's unbelievable. There are certain things you can get upset over and certain things you really shouldn't. And I think we've lost those priorities now for a while. Well, then again, we also like to do things in society that we just basically point out, hey, look what we're doing good! And in reality, all they're doing is doing like one thing good, which is like, say, oh, you helped a granny cross the street. When you could have made, when you could be, you know, solving the cure for cancer or something like that. You know, I know I'm... Alright, another way to explain it would probably be more negative stuff, like how saying a bad word is getting more publicity than, murdering somebody. Just a random out-of-nowhere homicide. And what makes national news? Well, the bad word. It's like, yeah. If you really want to do something, I would rather, stop a murder as opposed to, point at people for saying a bad word. I don't know. I think that's just me. I mean, it could be somebody else, but it could be just me. Anyway, got Strong Kong, Strong Kongus, and the jetpack barrels, which... pardon me. Blame that on the beer I have. The beer of choice today is something I never had. Lyman Kugel's Summer Shandy, which is pretty delicious. It's got a citrusy taste to it. But... it's very light. It just tastes very light. Like I said, quicksand apparently... does this, and with thin platforms, well, this can be a real pain in the ass, so usually there's times where I'll just say, you know what, screw it, and run through as if there's nothing there. And I really should just take care of the banana port so I don't have to keep going through this damn tunnel, including the claptraps here. Also, thanks for not doing what I asked. And there we go, number two. And, number three and four. So, time to take number two and go back. Because there's some stuff we can take care of right now. As usual. Actually, let me take, banana port one. Go here, because there was one thing we could do with Donkey Kong's, thing. And that was these switches right here. And that's open this gate. And we'll get our chance to use our first character barrel. Now, Crank did mention something about crystal coconuts. And how did I learn about crystal coconuts actually being relevant? Well, it's actually... part of the CGI TV show. I actually have a VHS tape called Donkey Kong Country, The Legend of the Crystal Coconut, which is basically a collection of three or four TV episodes meshed into one meshed into a feature length, which basically takes care of this. And the Crystal Coconut did have very, very mystical powers. So yeah, proof of thought. If you're wondering where it came from, the Crystal Coconut concept, it probably came from that. Also, not a really good place to be taking care of business. But, whatever. Can make it work. I forget where the CGI was originally aired. It might have... I want to say it was something from in a French... In Quebec. It might have been... It was something French. I know that. It was developed somewhere in France. Or somewhere French. I just don't have enough knowledge on it. I'll probably end up doing some research on it afterwards to see for sure. Probably won't take me long to find. But I feel like it's something that would be developed by maybe like Quebec or something. And also, we got C-Tiny, who is very small, as you'd imagine. Also, attacks with her hair. She is supposed to be related to Dixie, after all, and she has a baseball slide. Oh, and does a barrel roll. She took the barrel roll away from DK. And she gets a saxophone, which is pretty nice. But that's only one thing I'll need. And yeah, she's flirting with Tiny as well. So I guess candy can go for anybody. Maybe not, I don't know. I'm not gonna pretend I do know, because I'm not the master of this stuff. I'm not going to ask any more questions. Anyway, the baseball slide is pretty effective. It'll knock Kremlings out in one hit. Kind of like the barrel roll ball. Now let's test out the barrel roll right now. After all, Kremlings just right there. Thankfully, there's more coins, so that's awesome. Because I'm going to want to visit Cranky and at least get her the, her applicable power. Wow, that actually worked. Dumb luck. I'm not a fan of Tiny at all. I really just don't like using her. She has horrible vertical leap, as you'd imagine, being so tiny and not having much, not having much muscle. And naturally, her first power is to become even smaller. Also, what did Cranky put in those potions? And once again, another character barrel, which means another Crystal Coconut consumer. But we've taken care of most of everything with Angry Aztec at this point. Usually I just spend more time just taking care of the what I call the skeleton of a level. Which is basically just taking care of all the stuff around so I can link up areas, teleporters, things like that. And then just go from there, and that'll take care of the nitty-gritty afterwards. I still want to get some coins, though, for Tiny, because I don't have... I don't have the coins to visit Funky at this point. Ah, there we are. Ask and ye shall receive. So I'm just going to get Tiny's weapon, and then after that... I'm gonna take care of one thing here, and then I'll probably end up going back to Joel Japes and take care of some other stuff. So anyway, here's Tiny's weapon, a feather bow. It is a piece of shit. It takes like 14 shots to kill just a basic Kremlin. So yeah. A piece of shit, indeed. Anyway, you know what? I'll take care of DK's thing right now, and then afterwards. Also, they do have specialized music while they're in the tag barrels. here.
And they also have pretty funny animations. If you leave them alone for a while, they actually have some pretty amusing stuff. I think Tiny juggles an orange. An orange grenade. Yeah, I know, right? They add, yeah, they actually will do stupid things like that. They will actually juggle orange grenades and stuff on their toes and like, not exactly advisable, if you ask me. Anyway, here's our llama. Here's the llama on the door. What could it possibly mean? It means you gotta use this. Duh. And this one has automatic shots, which basically, I don't know if it's supposed to try to distract you or whatever, but it doesn't end up doing anything because you can't shoot until you get the animation to shoot. And you go through the DK star. Things happen. Good things, usually. In this case, we free up the llama. Yep, that's our reward, an old banana. I could totally feel your appreciation. And now we actually get switches for the llama temple. Which, actually, you know what? I'm gonna expand this part a little bit. Because, well, there's some stuff I can take care of now. I'll get that banana off screen, I guess. But there's a main reason. And you know what? Nah, it'll take me a while to do. I'll just take care of that first thing next part. Just let me collect the golden banana and I'll be on my way. And you won't have to put up with my crap for another day or two. I wish DK moved a little faster. Actually, I'm now convinced Diddy does move faster than Tiny and DK. Anyway, that's that. Okay. I love it, banana, and we'll see you next time. Bordy Warrior signing off.